tech Stephen Grocott this morning from Queensland Pacific Metals. Stephen, good morning.
Good morning, and I'm speaking for a change from sunny Townsville now that borders are open.
Indeed. Well, good to have you back, Stephen. Timely, you've had this announcement this week around an ore supply deal with SLN. Give us an overview as to the announcement.
So we had an MOU with SLN for the supply of 0.8 million tonnes a year, and now we've just cemented that in the form of a binding contract between SLN and ourselves. So they actually increase the amount of ore that they're going to supply. I mean, they're the largest miner in New Caledonia, and it's great to be working with a party of that calibre. I mean, they're also 51% owned by the French giant Eramet. There's an obvious alignment there with ore supply and ore use. The ore that they provide is one that currently doesn't really have much of a home at the moment. It's the top part of the ore body, which is rich in iron, and others can't process that, but we can. We're omnivorous, we can process all ores. So it's a very good fit, and also an ESG standards, because you know they have extremely high ESG standards in their mining and rehabilitation, and that fits very well with our world-class standards.
Just building on what you're saying there, Stephen, why have you opted for New Caledonian ore supply?
It's a very good question. And it wasn't even until I joined QPM that I fully understood that. You look at a map of the world and you see how close New Caledonia is. It's just a couple of hours flight, and it's about 9 days shipping. So it's very, very close. So transportation's a non-issue. But New Caledonia, one of the world's largest miners of very high-grade nickel ores. And as I said, there's this top part of the ore body that they currently mine through and direct primarily into waste because there's no home for it. And so that's one of the reasons for partnering with them. Plus, their ESG standards are exemplary. They're world-class in all their mining and rehabilitation. So that's one of the reasons. So geographic proximity, good environmental standards, and it's on a nickel equivalent basis, the highest grade nickel laterite limonite, or I'm getting a bit technical there, limonite's the top part. It's the highest nickel grade equivalent limonite ore in the world. So perfect fit.
I see the supply deal is for up to 1 million wet metric tons a year. My understanding is you need 1.5 million. So where are you looking to for the balance?
Yes. That's right. We're in discussions with a number of other miners. We already have MOUs with a couple of other miners, so we're progressing through that to develop similar contracts. So that's progressing well, so we're not worried about that at all. There's a half a dozen decent-sized miners in New Caledonia, all who are very, very good. So we're in discussions with each of those. It's always good to have more available than you need, partly for competitive tension, but also for security of supply, weather events and things like that.
I see your last bullet point on the announcement, Stephen. SLN and QPM have also agreed to continue to explore other partnership opportunities around additional ore supply plus potential tech project participation. What are you alluding to here?
Yes, careful what I say. I guess that builds, Andrew, on the points I was making at the beginning about the strategic fit between us and them. So both parties have an interest in exploring and making this a much longer term agreement between the two companies. And there are various strategic options that people can see, obviously around long-term ore supply and sharing some of the mutual interests around it. I have to be careful what I say, but it's pretty obvious that when you have two companies that have such a good natural fit, that you try to put that on a firmer and longer term basis for the benefit of both sides. So that is something that they asked for in that, it's something that we asked for, and we're in discussions and we'll continue those meetings over the coming months.
And what's the current status, Stephen, of the tech project? How are things moving ahead?
For those of the listeners and viewers, will recall me describing ourselves as box tickers. We have continued to tick boxes. So our feasibility study is progressing well, due to be complete sometime around the middle of the year. Our ore supply, you've already seen the progression there. Our gas supply is advancing extremely well. Approvals are on track. Importantly, and it's not a very sexy thing that gets a lot of news, but importantly, the relationship with the key equipment suppliers that we have chosen to work with is progressing extremely well. And we're, you know, very, very pleased with the caliber of their engineering teams and the quality of their equipment. So that's validating our choice of them. So that's progressing extremely well. That all contributes to having a very good DFS.
Very good to see you. Stephen, thanks very much.
Thank you very much.